So I guess what troubles me is this. You style yourself an originalist, textualist, factualist, whatever the term is, which means you go right to the words and try to understand the words and their original meaning. And so if I change Senator Feinstein's question and didn't ask you whether the president has the authority to unilaterally delay a general election, asked you instead, does the president have the authority to unilaterally deny the right to vote to any person based on their race? What would your answer be?
Well, Senator, obviously there are many laws in effect, including the Equal Protection Clause, which prohibits discrimination on the basis of race, including the 15th Amendment, which protects the right to vote against discrimination based on race. And so there's a principle in constitutional law called external constraints. And even if one evaluates what the authority a branch might have to act, there are external constraints that press in from other parts of the Constitution. Here, it would be the 14th and 15th Amendments.
Well, of course it would. The 15th Amendment, the right of citizens of the United States to vote shall not be denied or abridged by the United States or any state on account of race. For an originalist and a textualist, that is clear text as I see it. But when asked whether or not the president has any authority to unilaterally deny that right to vote for a person based on race or even gender, are you saying you can't answer that question?
Senator, I just referenced the 14th and 15th Amendments, the same one that you just repeated back to me, that do prohibit discrimination on the basis of race in voting. So as I said, I don't know how else I can say it, the Constitution contains provisions that prohibit discrimination on the basis of race in voting.
But whether a president can unilaterally deny, you're not going to answer yes or no.
Well, Senator, you've asked a couple different questions about what the senator, what the president might be able to unilaterally do, and I think that I really can't say anything more than I'm not going to answer hypotheticals.
It strains originalism if the clear wording of the Constitution establishes a right and you will not acknowledge it.
Well, Senator, it would strain the canons of conduct, which don't permit me to offer off-the-cuff reactions or any opinions outside of the judicial decision-making process. It would strain Article 3, which prevents me from deciding legal issues outside the context of cases and controversies. And as Justice Ginsburg said, it would display disregard for the whole judicial process.
They're really showing themselves to do really well. Come on, man.